assistance on Fab Friday. Teachers, take a look at these kiddos. These are the guys that every Friday morning, we have them look for kids that have the best assembly manners between that 7:40 to 8:05 time. And these guys are kind of our secret spies, and they help pick the next person that gets to be our special assistant every Friday for our assembly. So I know that all of us have seen you guys, but the teachers hadn't yet seen who has gotten picked so far. And Mrs. Vick and I don't pick, they choose who they think, the kids choose who they think has the best spirit assembly manners. So give them a round of applause. We'll be looking for our new assistant tomorrow, so be ready for that. Okay, we're gonna show all of our special guests that are here today just how we do it on Fridays, how we stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. So fifth grade, would you please stand up? Not too bad. Fourth and third grade, can you top that? Okay, second grade, you had a lot of good role models that you just watched. Show us how you can stand for the pledge. So very respectfully, we're going to say the Pledge of Allegiance, and the flag is over here in the corner of the stage. Okay, here we go.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, quietly remain standing. Remain standing. We're going to say our character pledge. So let's see if you remember it. Here we go.
Respect, responsibility, and citizenship too. They bring out the best in me and you. Trustworthiness and being fair help to show others that we really care. We all
been running late on time. So, we haven't done it for a while, and I bet we have some new students in the audience that have never heard a responsible song. So with really good singing voices and really good focus, let's sing the responsible song the best we can. You may stand.
Able to respond, I'm able.
motto, and our school motto, our saying that we live by, is let's embrace all learners and celebrate all accomplishments. So that's why we have our spirit assemblies once a month, is that last part, well, all of it really, to celebrate all that you've accomplished, both character-wise and academic-wise. So we are gonna start with our character champs from last month. And last month, our word of the month was leadership. Fifth grade did a great job of making those videos to show us what it means to be a leader. So we have a lot of kids in our school that have shown great leadership this month. So when we call your name, if you would quickly come to the stage, one of our character ambassadors will give you a dog tag. For second grade, Miss Terry's class, Tara Mitchell. In Miss Chittum's class, Cadence Woodall. For Miss Holman's class, Sadie Baez. Miss Dribble's class, Weston Grant. For Miss Yankee's class, Lydia Hicks. For Miss Matthews' class, Jackson Morton. For Miss Lockwood's class, Tiger Cobb. For Miss Hedger's class, Ben Boyle. For Miss Westhoff's class, Abby Smith. For Miss Hatfield's class, Dayston White. Fourth grade, Miss Bartlett's class, Emma Hawkins. Kaylin Brooks. For Miss Elwood's fourth grade, Emily Lear. For Miss Davis's class, Keegan Parnell. Okay, we'll get him in his dog tag. Hargrove's class, Meredith Baker. Going on to fifth grade, Miss Atkinson's class, Chloe Barnhill. For Miss Bain's class, Madison Wise. For Miss Sinclair's class, Megan Jennings. For Miss Thompson's class, Keisha Berry. Council presidents, people that are leaders in their school, I bet we see some future ones there. Moving on to our students of the month, these are students that have shown excellent academic success this month, and it could mean that they're great academically or they've just made great improvements and tried really hard. We want to celebrate these winners. We're going to start with fifth grade this time. We're going to start with from Ms. Witt's class, Nelson Pipes. Class, Renee Conklin. From Miss Sinclair's class, Jesse Anderson. From Miss Baines, Timothy Lapsley. From Miss Atkinson's class, Mason Robbins. From Miss Hargrove's class, Stella Craig. Miss Davis's class, Hannah Broughton. Miss Elwood's class, Dalton Whipple. For Miss Schwartz's class, Johnny Tomlin. For Miss Bartlett's class, Scarlett Hutchins. For Miss Hatfield's class, Garrett Wade. crafts class, Austin Hunts. Miss Hendricks' class, Jonathan Pope. For Miss Lockwood's class, Andrew Cabrick. For Miss Matthews' class, Mitchell Zimmerman. For Miss Yagi's class, Michael Fisher. For Miss Struble's class, Shelby Ricketts. For Miss Holman's class, Trayton Lynn. For Miss Chittum's class, Libby Kate Jones. Avery Winters. Let's give one more round of applause to these great students of the month. Students of the month, would you follow Mr. Meyer back to the music room to get your picture taken? Well, leadership was our word last month, and we're on to a new word this month. And our third graders have put together a great show to help introduce our new word of the month. So I'm going to turn it over to third grade, and doesn't Miss Hatfield look fantastic? She looks kind of stripped, you better watch out.
Character words. The first character word was the word respect. You gave many great examples of how to show respect. You said you can show respect to yourself by turning in your homework. You also said that you can respect
your teachers!
Yes, I was just about to say that. Please remember to raise your hand. Another character word was the word pride. Does someone have an example of how we can show pride for our school? Yes, that's correct. Please mind your manners, students. Now, to continue with our discussion, we also talked about another character word. What character would you be demonstrating if you were to stand in front of your class and give a presentation?
Courage!
My students, you are forgetting your manners. Remember to be respectful. Now, where was I? Oh, yes, discussing the word courage. Well, we will just move on to a different character word.
Gratitude.
Yes, oh my goodness, please remember to show respect. This month, we celebrated a famous American's birthday. Martin Luther King Jr. was a man who showed respect, pride, courage, gratitude, but also another word.
Compassion!
That's correct, students. Please stay calm. Now, we need to talk about this month's character word. Please, does anyone know what our character word for the month would be?
Crazy worry, messing with my head, this fear, I'm so sorry,
You know you gotta get it out. I can't take it. That's what being friends about.
We can all do the dance again together, okay? But you have to use your proper assembly manners, okay?
Don't make me go mean Mrs. Hatfield on you. I'll do it. Thank you for all those zero signs I see quickly. No, we're not playing black magic. I know a lot of you, when you see this bucket, you think I'm pulling out a name for black magic. I took the black magic guesses out, put them on the floor of my room so I didn't throw them away, and I put our tomahawk tokens in here. So don't worry, I'll have it with black magic tomorrow at the assembly. We need to pick a winner. I have been so happy to hear all the tomahawk tokens are getting written. Doesn't it make you feel good to hear some of the nice things that people are saying about you? Or even each other or school? It has just made me very happy to hear them every morning. I love listening to those. So it's time for us to draw a name out. I'm gonna have one of my helpers here. Tanner, you wanna help me? He's gonna pull out a student first, and this student gets to spin the wheel to see what prize they win. This person is Stayston White. Stayston, I just read this morning from your good friend Caitlin Casey. And the Tomahawk token said, Stayston is always there when I'm feeling down and cheers me up. Thank you, Stayston. So, Stayston, you get to go over to the computer. She's going to spin the wheel. What'd she get? Oh, wild card, you get to choose anything on the wheel. Do you want SSR with Mrs. Fick, a week of past, what? Preferred lunch and to eat lunch seat with a friend. So she gets to sit wherever she wants to, with a friend at lunch next week. Give her a round of applause. Okay, now it's time for the teachers. All right, Tanner. We have some nice ones that students have written. Some of them other teachers have written for fellow teachers. Some of them are from parents that wrote ones to teachers, and we love hearing all of those. So let's see which teacher's gonna get it this time. Well, what a coincidence. Mrs. Hatfield. See, Mrs. Hatfield, being that mean teacher paid off, huh? Mrs. Hatfield gets to spin to see what she wins. She might get sodas for her third grade team, or an extra 30 minutes of play-in time, or a jeans day. Let's see where it lands. Jeans day! Woohoo! Nice, so she gets, teachers aren't supposed to wear jeans except for on Fridays for Spirit Day, so she gets to pick another free day during the week to wear jeans. Awesome. Okay, we have two things left in our assembly. One's a maybe, okay? The first one is that we're gonna end like we normally end with the proud song, and if you can do a really great job with our proud song today, then we'll stay an extra couple minutes and we'll do the determination song, okay? So, Sheldon, can I stand for the proud song, please? was the best proud song I've ever seen you do. We had a little bit of self-control problems with a few people. Please remember that when we do that and we link arms, you're just swaying lightly. We're not yanking. A few years back, we had to end up doing the proud song sitting down, and we weren't allowed to stand up to do it anymore because of people having that problem. We wouldn't want that to happen again, so I know that you can do a great job with it. I have an announcement before we end today. I need all of the character champs and students of the month that just won today. We have to redo the picture with Mr. Roger. Something was wrong with the camera and it did not come out right. So before you leave today, if you are a character champ or student of the month, make sure you stay and go back to the music room, and we'll do character winners, the leadership winners first.